welcome to Business, Faith, and Family. I'm your host, Christina Harris. You're here tuned into the BFF Show. I have here with me Dhayany Walker from Dhayany Walker Love and Business. And I want to thank you for coming onto the show.
Of course.
And just tell us a little bit about yourself.
Dhayany Walker. So I have a website and a blog, dhayany.com. And my husband and I pretty much mentored hundreds of relationships. And we came to the conclusion that we need to start a blog and a website and really start getting our information that we've learned, that we've gathered with all these relationships. And what we realized was that not a lot of people are dating with a purpose. Because every situation comes up, like it's just over and over, the same problems, the same issues. And if you don't have that solid foundation or the solid reason why, then it really just becomes a situationship versus a relationship.
Yes.
So we came up with a blog and we just do conferences all around the world in reference to how to get relationships from a situationship to a relationship and how to be at a power couple status.
Oh, wow, great. And how did you and your husband actually fall into the same purpose?
Oh, which is amazing. So I've been married now 7 years.
Wow.
Yeah, 7 years. We got married in 2010. We just celebrated our 7 years in October. And we did marital counseling, premarital counseling, actually. So about a year and a half before we got married, we were mentored by our wonderful, amazing apostle, Warren Martin. And he is what got us our relationship from being just a regular relationship with issues, with our ex this and, you know, other family members and the relationship, et cetera. And he got us, he like built our foundation with us. Like he helped us build a solid foundation. And in that we realized that our passion, we share the same passion. We were able to unveil that by taking out all the issues and the drama and just the little pettiness that just created so much mess in our relationship. When we started taking and unwinding that from our relationship, we realized that we have so much in common, which is business. Hence, Love and Business is our blog. Realized that we have business in common and that we are full of purpose within that together. And we just created that to be our mission in our relationship.
Great, and knowing you both, that's one of my favorite attributes for your as a power couple, is the fact that you both pick God first. You don't see that too often. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I really commend you guys for doing that. And
that
set the standard for, I know for me, and a lot of other couples as well. Mm-hmm. Because too often we try to work things out in our own flesh and we eliminate God from our relationship. So that's really awesome. I really commend you guys on doing that.
I'll be honest. I learned that, and I thank you for acknowledging that. I learned that in college. I realized that if I go to school and I'm graduating from Temple and I had to go through all these years of education, then who's my guide in a relationship the same way? Mm-hmm. I had to graduate from God University,
yes,
seriously.
Yeah.
I had to understand who I was. My husband had to understand who he was before we were able to enter in this communion together as one. Or not, we're just gonna be failing classes,
yep,
like throughout the whole entire time. And who wants to go through that? I wanna graduate a cum laude status or more, right? So I wanted my relationship to do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I realized that I needed to do the premarital counseling, and you will forever do counseling in your relationship. It should be ongoing, just like education is. And we realized that that was the beginning and the reason for our solid foundation.
Great, I love that. Continue education in your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I brought you here today because amongst a lot of the other information that you put out for couples and people who are in relationships, you have something called the 12 Commandments of a Power Couple.
Yes,
I love it. I've been through your blog. The blog is awesome. Please make sure you visit her blog.
Thank you.
Explain that. How did that even come about?
Well, I mean, you have laws, right? And that's with everything. Every single thing you come across, you have some kind of policy, procedure. There's something to follow. There's a manual. You buy something from IKEA, it gives you step by step, which theirs are so clear and concise, right?
Yeah.
It's like, it's amazing. So I try to mimic that a little bit. In your relationship, how do you go from having a situationship to having an actual powerful relationship, a relationship just drilled and fueled with purpose? So the number one thing for me in the 12th commandment, the number one commandment, you have to know your role in your life.
That's good.
And we make that mistake going into a relationship with someone and you don't even know what you want to do with yourself. And you bring the second party into this situation and you don't even know what to do with it. And then you want them to understand you. You don't understand you yet, you know? And it's like, how am I supposed to understand you and you have no idea, you're clueless. So we're gonna, these two personalities are coming together trying to figure this one out, and then you still gotta figure the other person out. 9 times out of 10, they don't know their purpose. And if they do, it's amazing, because maybe they can guide you through it, but no one can help you find you. You have to find you.
Absolutely.
So that's definitely my number one commandment from the 12 commandments, is know your role. That is so important. Before you start dating, and I get it, maybe you're already in a relationship, and how do I find my person? I'm already in a relationship. It's okay to take a time out.
That's right.
You know, there's a reset button for everything.
That's
reset
right.
your relationship and find out what is it that you want out of life, so that you can then understand if this is the person for you. Because if 10 years from now, your goal is to live in Hawaii and just be on vacation, or live there forever, or take your career there, and you don't want any kids, etc. But you're with someone that loves Philadelphia, wants to stay in Philly, wants 5 kids, newsflash, you're gonna, like, you're just in role for destruction right now, because it's just not going to work. You know, you guys don't have that common ground.
Yeah.
So definitely know your role.
Yes, and that's why taking your time, getting to know each other is important. I often actually use that same mantra for happiness. You know, too often we, as women, sometimes we place the burden of being happy on the shoulders of the man that's in our life.
Mm-hmm.
And the older we get, the different seasons we have in our life, happiness looks a little different, you know? So I think it's a little unfair to put that burden on someone to keep up with our happiness when happiness is everlasting, well, ever-changing, I'll say. What's your second favorite?
I love that. Can I skip to third? Because that's what you're saying.
Okay.
As a power couple, contentment is not an option.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you are in power couple like status, or you want to be, understand that you're constantly involving change. You're constantly evolving. Your happiness changes. What your partner views as is nice or beautiful may change, and that you're okay with that. You know, when you have the argument in a relationship where this is how it was 5 years ago and now you have a problem with it. Yes, it changed, and be okay with that. You know, what my husband found sexy 7 years ago may not be sexy now, and I should be okay with that. And I'll change it and change it to the sexiness that he deems to be sexy.
Yes.
You know, I shouldn't have an issue with that, and vice versa. So not only with appearance, but in general, career path. Your career path has changed how many times?
Mm-hmm.
You know, your husband should be okay with that, or your partner should be okay. That change is going to happen.
Yes.
And that really the only way to grow is through change.
That is true. Wow. Well, I just, you know, you're a woman filled with wisdom.
Amen.
And I think that's what we need. I think too often we aren't transparent enough with each other.
Mm.
And we aren't open to, you know, just look at where we've been and help others to get to that place.
Mm-hmm.
You're listening to the BFF Show. I'm your host, Christina Harris. I have Dhayany Walker here with me. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. Hey, welcome back to Business, Faith, and Family, the BFF Show. I'm your host, Christina Harris. I have here with me Dhayany Walker, and we are just talking about the 12 commandments of a power couple. Thank you again for joining us here on the BFF Show. What would you say is your all-time favorite power couple commandment?
Definitely how to manage your time. And so once you're at power couple status, obviously you have a lot in common, a lot to share. A lot of your businesses may be together, input always together. You guys are constantly giving each other feedback because you're all about growth and growing together and raising your empire, etc. So because of that, you do a lot of work together. So at the same time, managing that time, because that's important, but also space.
Mm-hmm.
And that's commandment number
that's good.
7. A lot of times we get so caught up with each other business-wise that we forget to find ourselves as individuals.
Mm-hmm.
And that's important for growth. You know, I need to grow beyond what my husband and I do every day. Like, I need to find me. I need to know what my habits and my fun time is and what my alone time is. Outside even my family, I have 2 beautiful children. They're amazing. Milani and 3D, and we spend a lot of time together, again, because we work from home, or we have the same businesses, we check on them the same, we have meetings together. A lot of times we're with our kids. So there is that has there has to be that you time, whether it's your own projects that you have going on, like the blog Dhayany.com. It is me, but I get a lot of my husband's input because it is about relationship and love, and we're in it together. Yeah. He gives me a lot of feedback, what to share, so that it's not just from a woman's perspective. And to me, that's important too, because it's not just the woman in the relationship, it's also the man in the relationship. So the female also needs to understand the man's point of view and why he feels the way he feels. So that's what my husband brings to the table as well when it comes to our site.
Great. Now, even on the topic of the commandments of a power couple, what would you define a power couple as?
You definitely have to have that relationship that is the epitome of just difference, being a game changer. Individually awesome. You guys are two amazing people, regardless if you're with each other. But when you're with each other, it's like dynamite.
That's true.
You're willing to change the world together. Mm-hmm. You know, so and then the key here, and you'll hear it consistently in the definition, is together as one, where you guys both share the same views. You guys both want to change the world together. You guys both want to grow this empire together. You're not afraid to be different together. Mm-hmm. You have a lot of common values, you know, and it's the same. A lot of people say, you know, well, opposites attract too. Yes, that is true. But imagine the same. We could go endless here if we have the same values, you know. So I'm not saying the opposites won't work. I mean, there's a lot of things, well, not too many things, but there are some things my husband and I don't necessarily always agree with. But we sit down, we listen to each other's point of view and realize we're probably saying the same thing, you know, just differently because we translate it differently.
Yes.
But you have to be the epitome of that relationship that other people want. And not just when they see you, but also at home when your family sees
you.
That
is really
right? Because those are the number one people that judge you is your own family. Yeah. Like, that's not really who they are.
Yes, and even from a biblical perspective, the Bible says that we are to become one. The two are to become one. And I love exactly what you said, because that's actually a biblical principle of becoming one also in your purpose. You know, becoming one in your mindset for Christ. All those things are awesome, and it all give glory to God in your relationship. And that's when I personally feel like that's when you really allow God to come in, and He'll give you the creativity. He'll give you the grace to be able to not only have the free time to enjoy with your children and work with your husband, but you guys have the grace to do it together, you know? So I really appreciate, and it sounds as if as well that not only did you guys do and have that foundation, but you also are living the principles as well. And that's pretty awesome. You don't get that as much. You don't get that as much. Out of all the power commandments, which one really hits home for you personally?
I would say being around like-minded. I know we spoke about it earlier, and I feel like all of them do, because I literally came up with all of them because of our personal relationship, what we learned throughout the process. And yes, it's only been 7 years, but it's literally been 7 years of not just studying each other, not only being mentored by like our best mentors that we have ever, but also by hearing other people's testimonies and stories as well. So it is a combination of real life things. But I would say for us, definitely when it comes to working together as one, giving each other space too, and being around other like-minded relationships and people that are in a relationship or want to be. We definitely surround ourselves by a really tight group of people. A majority of them are in a relationship. Some maybe not anymore, but they want to. It's still something that they have that's similar. The values are very similar. That's important to us, because I need to make sure, and vice versa, but I need to make sure that my husband is surrounded by men. And the topic of discussion is something that I would enjoy them speaking about. Okay. You know, we go around other circles, other group of people, and I hear men talking about, yeah, I mean, well, men cheat sometimes, and it's all good, that's what they do. It's like, that's not what they do. No, that's not true. And then to hear other women, like their wives, and it's like, you are okay with him being around this group of men? That's definitely not what the kind of men that I want my husband to be fed, you know, or just constantly have conversation with. And vice versa with me. I don't want a whole bunch of women around me that are constantly, well, I cheat once in a while, my husband doesn't know. That's just not the type of conversation I want to be around. So we actually have a power couple group, and we're around each other. We just feed each other positivity. We make sure that men see other men and how they strive, because it is important for men to be around other strong men.
That's
and understand that not all men are always strong. There's weak moments. There's moments that having your family, your business on your shoulder gets overwhelming. You know, what do you do? Do you you know, cry on another woman's shoulder. No, you go to God, seek God, you know, and have your group of guys that are always, you know, around each other and positive and just uplift each other.
Absolutely. Yeah. I just love it. Who would you say is your model of a strong power couple?
Wow. Model, I'll tell you some that I look up to. Model are people definitely that may not necessarily be known out in the public, which my parents, my husband's parents, our pastor, Pastor Martin and his wife, they're amazing. You know, these are our mentors. We also have a mentor, Maritza Hernandez and Fredo. These are all mentors of ours when it comes to relationship and marriage. These are people that actually live it. Do not mind sharing their testimony and how they fell, and this is what they did, to listen to us when we're down and give us sound advice, and with words slap us right in the face because we're wrong, you know? So these are all couples, but someone in the public eye, someone that I admire, and it's not because of their talents, but it's because of the glory that you see and the change when they became a power couple, I would say Jay-Z and Beyonce. It's definitely one of my all-time favorites, and I was mentioning it earlier. You see, if you follow Jay-Z's journey, even from music, you realize his growth and his maturity as soon as he married, and as soon as Beyonce walked into his presence, she made a change. And that's what I mean, even for women in a relationship, make an impact in your future husband's life before even you guys become married. Your presence should be such a difference in his life that his friends thank you for being in his life.
Awesome.
Versus
that's
curse you because you took his homie and now you created him to be a hot mess or something like that. So I would say that's definitely one of my ultimate favorites.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And, you know, even as I just think about, if I ask myself that question from a biblical perspective, I love the story of Mary and Joseph. Mm-hmm. Because here they had to, their purpose was undefined at first, and they had to come together. You got a virgin birth, all right? They had to come together to touch and agree on something that they didn't understand. Mm-hmm. You know, and I think, like you said, the individual and the collective purpose also means a lot. And then you don't want the woman, such as a Eve, who'll derail Adam from his purpose, you know, and have him to fall, I'll say, you know, because of her lack of obedience or whatever it is. I love that you said that there's times when that being on the same mindset with other people is so important. And I love the fact that you even brought that to the forefront of how men do get weak too. And not always weak as far as with temptation and things like that, but just carrying everything on their back. So we're going to take a quick break. You're listening to the BFF show here on Business, Faith, and Family. We'll be right back. Hey, welcome back to the BFF show here with your host, Christina Harris. I have with me Dhayany Walker, and we are just talking about power couples, the 12 commandments of a power couple, and we've discussed so much. Then, thank you for coming onto the show. I really appreciate it.
Cool.
What would you say is how does your faith play a part in all that you do? Like, to even get to this point of your life with your husband, 7 years. All right, is a long time to be married to someone. How does faith play a part in that?
Faith has definitely played a part our entire relationship until this day. I mean, the mere fact that we're in business, you know, we don't rely on someone giving us a paycheck.
Perfect.
It just doesn't happen.
Yep.
And by the way, we don't rely on, and even in our business, our faith is completely on God providing for us, like literally. A funny thing, seriously. So it's to the point where even my team, we talk about the faith all the time and also tithing. And one of my team members today, so she said, we were having a really good day. You know, everything was kind of just rolling. And she was like, that's because I paid my tithes yesterday, Ms. D. But that's because, you know, we're constantly talking about things, constantly evolving faith with everything. But faith has definitely played a main part in our relationship. Mm-hmm. My husband, Mr. Walker, he was out there. Mm-hmm. You know, he wasn't. He didn't come into the relationship. Let's just say he wasn't a virgin, like way far from it, right? So it took a lot of faith on my end. I knew how many girlfriends, and to this day, he has plenty of friends, female friends, plenty of them, and I love them all. You know, I can't name them all, but I love them all. And instilled that faith in the beginning of the relationship, knowing that there wasn't that cheating stuff, and I didn't have to worry about that. And he played his role as well, where he never made me feel like there was anything to hide. That's but there was awesome. Always those things, those barriers that you have to break with a man, mm-hmm. you know, where, why didn't you answer your phone at that time? That was a little, just answer it. It's not, you know, you have that conversation, et cetera. But it, I had to have faith from the very beginning, because he wasn't a man that wasn't known. Mm-hmm. You know, he was very well known. But I had to be secure and have faith in my God. And I'll tell you one thing, and I tell everyone, I talk about it on my blog. I do not trust my husband. Mm-hmm. That's not it. That's not where it comes from. My trust is not in him.
Okay.
My trust is in God. Mm-hmm. In the God in him, but I understand and I see that there is a God in him.
Okay.
So I get to trust the God in him because I see it. I know his presence. But the minute the God leaves him and is no longer present, I can no longer trust the God in him because I know it's not there. And I'm trusting the man, and I'm definitely not trusting the man.
Yes.
You know, so that's when I know the relationship is not what it was, because my relationship and my trust is in God, not in him.
And you know, I've actually, personally, I've experienced that. I have experienced, you know, like you said, you have faith, but in the God in that person. And if there's anyone out there who may be in a situationship, I love that you came out and said that. And if there's anyone out there who feel as though their relationship is not where you need it to be, I think the first thing is you both need to be at a place of complete submission and allow God to enter into your marriage, your relationship, because it is worth fighting for. And I love what you said, that your husband, there will be times where he will make you feel secure, you know, that you didn't have to question if he was doing things. And I think that's important as well. But I have experienced that where the God part and your mate has left. And now you, and the Bible says the flesh is hostile to the things of God. So that's even including the principle of God. And you're right, you can't trust this flesh, the mindset, you know, or anything. So it's so important to constantly have, the Bible says the man shall wash his wife with the word of God, you know. And I also think it's equally our responsibility as wives to make sure that we give our husbands that room to wash us, you know. Who wants to pray with you after you nagged them all day, for example? You know, let's be real. So I love that you've been open with us about these things. I love that you came up with the 12 commandments of a power couple. I really applaud you for that. Would you say, how do a lot of people respond? Do you think that people are attentive to what you're bringing to the table? Because not a lot of people open up, and I appreciate that. Not only are you mentoring married couple, you're also reaching back for those who are in a relationship, situationship, or just trying to fill it out. So I love that your range of helping people is vast. I really applaud you on that, you and your husband.
I would say that a majority of the people do come to us because they want to sit. And one of the things that we find is that unless both are ready for change, doesn't matter what we do. I mean, we can literally have the answers. You ever have someone say, oh, can you help me with this test? Oh, sure, here are the answers. Oh, no, I don't want to look at the answers. Well, what do you want me to do? So you want to study? Like, be specific with what,
right.
Be specific on what you want from me. Because if you're both not ready, you're not going to get it. Like, you both have to be ready for change. Because there has to be constant change in the relationship. You cannot be stuck with 1 year ago. What happened 1 year ago is 1 year ago, which is one of the commandments. Whatever happened, let it go. If you're still here present with your partner, whatever happened, let it go. It happened already. It's done.
If you're
not over it, then just go about your business and get over your feelings and come back. But you definitely have to be ready for the change, particularly if you both are sitting down at the table saying, I want something different. You have to do something different.
Yes, and I think the key word you said is both. Because there's times when you and your husband mentored me. So their key word was both. Second thing was change. And I strongly believe, like you said, if you are both striving to do, and you have to get over it. Sometimes you have to get over it. The Bible says that when we confess our sins to one another, we can be healed. You can't get healed until you get to a place of recognizing what it is that you do wrong. You know, and then you can't change unless you, like you said, you realize there has to be a change. Mm-hmm. So I know I've experienced that as well.
And I love that you said that, because I have this thing where you have to expose what the issues are, and it needs to be exposed. Forget this, we'll keep it in the closet, it's not that deep, or we won't talk about it, or just let it go, it'll fix itself. Yeah. Expose it, you will heal from it.
You're so right. And I think a lot of people need to be delivered from bad communication styles, you know, past relationships and hurts. And the difference between being delivered is when you allow God to give you a new mindset in that thing. You don't have, just because your father or your mother did something a one way, doesn't mean that's how you have to, you know, do things now, you know? So,
Can I add? Absolutely. And a lot of times I don't like jumping into this because it's a topic within itself, but you did earlier mentioned how did we find our purpose in the relationship? The number one thing, how it got to the point where it was completely exposed, we sexual had to end. We could not have that sexual connection anymore, that lust over each other anymore. That had to stop.
Oh, wow.
And again, I had a husband that, what is that? What do you mean we're not doing any of that, you know? But again, he was still very spiritually grounded.
Yeah.
So the minute that topic came up, there was no debating, arguing about it. It was, this is what we need to do. And we sowed that seed for 22 months.
Wow.
And no, it's gonna stop here. Why? We needed clarity. I didn't want anything to cloud us. And again, we did not know we were gonna get married. I just knew that if I wanna be successful, I was successful in college because I gave it my 100%. Mm-hmm. And if the professor said, study this, I will study that. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not gonna go and study something else or go party. This is what I'm gonna do. So I just applied the same logic in my relationship. If we're gonna do this and I want it to be successful, I have to give it my 100%. Mm-hmm. I can't give it my 100% you clouding me Friday night, us, you know, fooling around with each other. It's just not gonna happen. Mm-hmm. And we did that, we sowed that seed. And because of that, we got clarity in every area in our life. I would say nothing is perfect, but we got so much clarity that we understand what it is that we need to do to continue to make this a success.
Wow, well, good luck to you and your husband, your beautiful children. And you can find Dhayany where on your social media?
So
pages?
Everything is Dhayany, and that's Dhayany. So that's Dhayany.com, Facebook Dhayany, Dhayany Walker, Instagram Dhayany, Twitter Dhayany, Snap Dhayany, you name it, Dhayany.
And you can find all of the BFF clips on BFF Host under Facebook. You can find me under BFF Host, that's BFF HOST, under Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and even YouTube. Would you like to pray out for us?
Absolutely.
For the couples who may be struggling or just want to get to a place where they can be one in purpose.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I'm going to say a prayer, but definitely go to Dhayany.com and read over the commandments with each other. That is always, there will always be a blessing. Even if you declare that, you know, to yourself every night, that will definitely be something to do. So tonight we want to pray, Lord God, we thank you on this very night. We thank you for your many blessings, for your guidance, for your love and your mercy, Lord God. We pray on tonight for all the souls that are uncertain in their relationship, that are not sure, not only in their relationship, but also in their purpose in life, what it is, Lord God. And we ask that you guide them, Lord Jesus, guide them and bless and protect their heart, Lord Jesus, that they listen to you clearly and that they have a heart that you allow you to guide them. We thank you in advance for protecting their relationship as a whole, for clarity in the relationship, that you clean out any bad, any history, anything that is not of you, that it gets cleansed, Lord God, so that they're able to receive from you, that they're able to communicate effectively with each other, and that they're able to be forgive. They can forgive themselves even within the relationship, and that the other person, the partner, can also be forgiving in a relationship, that they're guided as one, and that they understand their purpose as a whole. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Yes. Well, thank you again for coming on to the show. I'm your host, Christina Harris. Thank you for watching the Business, Faith, and Family Show.